Right, guys, welcome back to the channel. And my painting mojo has not been what it should be over the last couple of months. So I decided to get in touch with my Patreons and say, send me your models. And I decided to take this as a bit of a challenge, paint something that I wouldn't normally paint, and obviously give something back to the Patreons as a massive thank you for them supporting me and standing by me. So we've got a couple of things that are going to be arriving soon. I'm hoping they come today. But we've got a monster, we've got a robot, and a couple of characters. Most of the people want them painting with box art, with the exception of an Imperial Knight that Mitch wanted painting up in House Raven. So let's dive right in. But I'm going to try and limit myself to, you know, just a couple of hours per model. Set myself a little bit of a challenge. Try and reinvigorate myself. And get that pin mojo back. So let's dive right in and see where we start. So with how eager I was, I've already started some of them by accident. So the models that we're going to be working on even is Adrax Agitone. This is going to be for Scott. We've got Blood Angels Chaplain, which Alex sent me. I've literally just built him up. So I'm going to enjoy painting this guy because I have done one before, obviously, but I love Blood Angels. I have done a couple of Salamanders before, but not this guy. Craig, meanwhile, has given me Fabius Bile to paint, which that's going to be really cool. All the leathers and stuff on his coat, that's going to be really, really sweet to paint. But of course, these are just like, you know, normal size heroes in HQ. Craig asked me to paint a monster. Yes, a monster. Archeon the Everchosen is what Craig asked me to paint up. He says he did start it, and see here he's obviously done a couple of bits of dry brushing and such, but wants me to finish it. And this is going to be a challenge, but it's going to be one of the most enjoyable challenges because I've already obviously painted mine up. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. It's one of the best miniatures that I've ever painted. So I'm looking forward to that. We've all obviously got Archeon there separate, ready to go as well. And I've got one more parcel which should be here at some point today. So I'm going to get Adrax built, get all these primed black while I wait for that. And I'll show you what the other parcel is now. So first up is Ajax Agitone, and we're going to try and paint this guy up in around about 2 hours. He's primed black, we've got Warpstone Glow in the airbrush, and we're going to give him a nice base coat. Once that's dry, we're going to do a Zenithal highlight using Moot Green. We're just going to apply this very, very finely onto the top raised bits, such as the shoulder pads, the toe caps, the knee caps, and so forth. Then we can start with the block colours. I'm starting here with Abaddon Black and then Lead Belcher. For the golds, I'm using Necro Gold by Scale 75. This is a very tarnished, deep gold, and I think this is going to look really nice on this miniature. So once all the trim is painted, there's also a couple of very small bits that we're going to use Corn Red on, and we're going to use Rakarth Flesh on the Purity Seal. And to really give this burnt feeling, I'm going to use AK Interactive Streaking Grime, and I'm going to cover all of the metals in this. Once I've left it to dry for about 10-15 minutes, I'm then going to use a Q-tip or a cotton bud if you're in the UK, with a small amount of white spirit on, and just start and wipe the streaking grime off the very raised surfaces of all of the metals. For the sculpted base, I dry brushed it using Eschen Grey, then Dawnstone, then Celestra Grey, and then around the edges and ridges where the lava would be, I actually used Corn Red. But next, we're going to hair it up with the white ink, and what we're going to do is paint all of the lava with this, just a very small amount of overspray onto the rocks, making sure that the white and brightest part of it is right in the middle of that lava plume. We're also going to do the exact same thing with the flame on the backpack as well. And then one of my favourite techniques is using Vallejo game fiery orange and over the top of white. This goes on very yellow, and the more you spray, the more layers you put up, it builds up to orange. But you can see here it starts off very nice and bright and yellow, and what we're going to do is work on the edges of the lava to make them more orange, whilst the centers will be yellow and very bright. And then with the flames, we're just going to make sure that we have less of the yellow down near the center and more layers up at the top, so that it's much deeper. And after a couple of extra details, such as some red on the scales of the cloak, and painting his face a very dark gray to represent that ashen color, he's pretty much finished. And I'm really happy with that. Managed to get this guy done in 2 hours. So I'm on a roll, and next I'm going to move on to the Blood Angels Chaplain. So naturally he is primed black, and we are going to start by using Cold Grey by Vallejo mixed with a little bit of black just to make it that bit darker. And we're going to do a top down zenithal spray on all of the black, just so that it's a little bit lighter than the actual base colour. Then, using a very fine brush, we're going to use Othuan Grey to edge highlight all of the muscles, the armor plates, and in particular the wing on the shoulder pad. Using the picture on the GW website as reference, I then use Corn Red and again Necro Gold from Scale 75 to block in all of the golds and the reds, whilst also watching one of my favorite YouTubers, Miniac. You can see here I've also used Rakarth Flesh on the Purity Seals, and we've covered all of the gold, the Rakarth Flesh, and the red in Agrax Earthshade. Once that's all dry, we're going to start highlighting up all of the red, so all of the individual muscle strands, the blood drops, and the Purity Seal. I also edge highlighted all of the wings on the backpack as well. Before we move on to airbrushing the jetpack itself, and for this I'm using Magic Blue by Vallejo, and we spray most of the jetpack itself, like where the jets are, in the Magic Blue. Once that is done, we then add a ton of white into the airbrush to make a much, much lighter blue, and then we concentrate on just the center of the blue that we've already painted, and it makes it that really, really bright blue glow. And once that's complete, we can put it all together, but you'll have to wait till the end of the video to see the model. All in all, about 90 minutes work. Now, unfortunately, I lost the footage for painting of Fabius Bile, but we did use Xeros Purple as the base for his armor, Necro Gold, of course, for the gold trim, and we started with Cadian Flesh Tone on the cloak, using Lead Belcher, of course, to highlight all of the metalwork. And again, unfortunately, I apologize regarding the footage, but I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. We used a couple of blues and some reds just to add details to the syringes and the pipes. But now, the main man and monster himself. We are starting on Archeon the Everchosen. I'm giving myself 3 hours to try and paint this guy. The first step of which is giving the dragon and his armor a zenithal highlight of that dark gray mix of cold gray with a little bit of black. Then the long haul, using Rakarth Flesh to do all of the wings and the underbelly and the tail. Now, we're not exactly doing all of the wings. We're going to paint the vast majority of the membrane and try and leave each of the spines, giving the center of the membrane a nice 2 or 3 coats to really build up that color, so that it blends more towards the spine on each wing and stays really bright and vibrant in the center of each section. To tie the rest of the model in, we're going to give most of the rest of the skin and armor plating a very, very fine dry brush of Rakarth Flesh, so it literally just picks up the highest raised parts of the model and just ties it into the wings. Then it's time to start on the heads of the dragons. We paint the majority of the Nurgle head using Vallejo Goblin Green. We paint the Corn head with Bloody Red. And whilst we've got the red in the airbrush, we're going to give a very, very fine layer of red along the edges of each of the membranes on the wings, just blending up about a third of the way and putting a little bit more red along the bottom edge. Then the Zinch head will be done with Ultramarine Blue by Vallejo. Going back to the wings, we use large dry brush to dry brush Rakarth flesh over the tops of the red that we've just done on the membrane. And again, that really, really helps blend it in and makes each of those ridges really pop. Then we use Retributor Armor to paint all of the trim of the armor, including on Archeon himself. Then we use Rakarth flesh for any skulls embedded in the arms, the legs, and of course any horns and beaks on the heads as well. We use dried bark and lead belcher for the leather and the chains on the dragon's back, and then we cover all of that, including the Retributor armor, using Agrax Earthshade. One thing I didn't get on video is we did wash each of the heads with their respective shades. So we used a Thornian Camel shade on the Nurgle head. We used Draconoff Nightshade on the blue, and we used Caribor Crimson on the red. We then dry brushed them using Wah Flesh for the Nurgle head. We used Temple Guard blue for the Zinch head, and we used Evil Sun's Scarlet for the Khorne head. We highlight all the gold back up using Retributor Armor once again, and we highlight the silver using Stormhorse Silver. And of course, all the bones are highlighted once again with Rakarth Flesh. To finish the model, we're going to paint the Slayer of Kings, and again, using white ink, I'm going to spray this down the sword around about two thirds of the way down, making sure that the brightest and most layers are at the very tip of the sword. And we're going to use the Fiery Orange technique so that it lights up really bright yellow at the top and blends more into an orange as you put a couple of extra layers down where it blends into the red. And when that's done, we'll stick it onto the base. So all in all, about 3 hours work to do Archeon the Everchosen. The vast majority of this was done by airbrush, wash and dry brush. And you know what? I'm really, really happy with the way this has turned out. Up next was Mitch's Knight. So this has some 3D printed shoulder pads that are a little bit different, and I built this in sub-assemblies, sprayed quite a lot of it in Mephiston Red, and then a lot of it in Lead Belcher. I used Balthazar Gold to paint on a lot of the nuts and bolts of the legs and the main body, and then used Caribor Crimson to wash all of the red. I also used Caliban Green and Avalon Sunset to paint all of the pipes green and yellow. Then using the airbrush, I used Vallejo Bloody Red and make sure that I brighten up the centre of all of those panels that we washed with Caribou Crimson. Using masking tape, I taped off the hull into a couple of V shapes, and then we sprayed a lot of it using brown. To get the desired effect and to make that yellow really shade, the brown is a perfect base color, but we highlight all of the center of the panels using my favorite, the white ink. Then of course we use the fiery orange over the top of all of that, and the brown creates a nice natural shade whilst the center of the panels is really bright and rich. We then use Lead Belcher to paint an absolute metric ton of bolts and all of the trims for all of the armor panels, the mask, the shin pads, and of course the gun guards as well. This part by far took the longest, but once that's done, we're going to move on to the muzzle burn on the battle cannon and the thermal cannon. And to do this, we use Glorious Gold by Vallejo Air, and we cover about a third of the tip of each gun using that. After that, we then used Hex Lichen to cover about two-thirds of that gold area, and you can see here it creates that nice sort of warm purple feeling at the end of the barrel. After that, we use the Ultramarine Blue to do just the very tip of the guns. I also do this on the exhausts on the back of the Knight as well. After that, we applied quite a lot of streaking grime to most of the silvers and golds, as well as some of the pipes, and put it to one side to dry. Once dried, we're going to use a couple of cotton buds or Q-tips, along with some white spirit, just to wipe off the very raised areas and help create those grimes and oily feel to the night. It's a big hulking robot. It's going to have a lot of oil and grease pouring out of it. Then it's time to assemble it. Not bad at all for about 3 hours work. Lots of big panels, and I really enjoyed putting this guy together. Now, as you can probably see, we did most of this on our Twitch stream. If you're not following us on Twitch, guys, go and make sure you give us a follow, where we do live hobby hangouts. But now it's time to have a look at the finished results. So there we have it. 5 amazing miniatures that I've thoroughly enjoyed painting up, courtesy of the Patreons for allowing me to do this. So a massive shout out to them. I really appreciate the opportunity, and it's really helped reinvigorate my drive within the hobby. I've been feeling a little bit struggling to find my mojo recently, and this really has helped me find it. And I'm looking forward to getting some more of my miniatures painted and out of the way. So shout out to the Patreons for that. I really do appreciate it, guys. Also, please make sure you are subscribed to the channel. And if you would like to support the channel, please consider becoming a Patreon. And make sure you give us a follow over on Twitch. But until next time, guys, thank you very much. And we'll see you again very soon.